Let me pray for a friend of mine than nothing to set before you. And he concluding shall answer and say, trouble me not, the door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot rise and give thee. I say unto him, though you will not rise and give him, because he is his friend, yet because of his importunity, you will rise and give him as many as he needed. Luke chapter 18. Click forward. Luke chapter 18, verse 6 to 8. And the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge said, and shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear not with them? I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth? May the Lord bless his word in your heart in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Please be seated, my kings, and queens. Now, we are continuing with our discourse on divine rules for divine provision. And we started last Sunday, and we looked at just rule number one. And what was rule number one? Hello, divine rules for divine provision. Rule number one. Yes. I can't hear you. Somebody can just rise up. Don't worry about your needs, but do what? Locate, find out the source that can sustain and make all provision. And we went ahead to say that for you to discover the source, you are looking for the kingdom of God. Because our text last Sunday that we read said, don't worry about this thing, but seek ye first what? The kingdom of God and his righteousness. And to seek the kingdom, you must find the king and dwell in his dominion. It's very good to know what you are looking for. If somebody says, I'm looking for a job, you say, what kind of job are you looking for? You say, just anything, child, is not going to get nothing. For he doesn't know what he is looking for. And as a direction, it has robbed many of us of our opportunity to break through. We have a brother who is a senator, and he says, how can I help you? Say anything, child. I'm not ready. The man will just say, don't worry. When anything shall comes, I will call you. And nothing shall will ever come in, because there is nothing that bears anything shall. Praise the Lord. So, when you say you are looking for divine provision, you are first and foremost must be looking for a kingdom where there is no lack. And the domain will deliver to you what you want. And when I have to say, for you to go into that domain, because the spiritual domain, you must have the emblem, and the emblem is righteousness. Because Hebrews 1:8 says, thy throne righteousness. I hope you can still remember that point. So let's move on. Today we are looking at rule number 2, divine rules for divine provision. Rule number 2. I'm not in a hurry to roll out so many points. I just want you to understand. When you have this understanding, no problem with you anymore. Even when there is no food, even when there is no food, you will have enough to cater for you. First and foremost, in your spirit. Because the spirit controls the physical. Are we communicating? And God is not guarantee us that there will be no lack. Did he tell us? No, he didn't tell us that there will be no lack. But what he told us is that he will meet all our needs. So when you lack, it's part of life. Be sure and suffer to stand when there is no lack. It's your knowledge of the world. The shock absorber, there is a hymn that says, "With your heart humble." That when you read that hymn, you will know that in every situation of life, knowledge is our anchor. When the billows roll, knowledge is our anchor. Engineers, listen to me here. Sarah, who is there? When there is that interference, all you need to do is just keep the antenna of the transmitter. Keep it all around you. Return it to its original position. Alright. So, rule number 2. Ask, seek, and knock in prayer. That's rule number 2. To get what you want from God, ask, seek, and knock in prayer. And this again is very, very large. Very, very wide. But we try and go as much as we can, or better go fast, so that we take at least another rule. Now, if you look at where they have prayed, the two places we read in the scripture, Jesus was telling us the importance of both asking, seeking, and knocking in prayer. He said, if somebody needs something, in the wee hours of the night, and goes to a friend to say, "Friend, I need 3 loaves of bread," which he knew that his friend has. The friend then was giving, because he's likely to say, "I'm asking John come back tomorrow." But Jesus Christ says, the only reason that will make that friend to give him what he wants is his importunity. Persistence.
We're going to talk about that later.
So, what is this saying about asking?
God is not a man that you just walk up to and say to him, "God, I need this gift." And he says, "Take this gift." "God, I need granite." He says, "Take granite." "God, I need a bag." He says, "Take a bag." No. God does not operate like that.
That is why many of us, we get frustrated
every time you want to say, "Neighbor." We are saying something important. Say neighbor. It's a matter of life and death we are discussing now. Say neighbor. It's not the time to sleep. Glory to God. We must understand that fact. God is not a man who just walk up to God and get whatever you want. He is our Father, no doubt. But like I said to you, many of us are fathers. Do you just give everything that you want, that your children want? Do you just give it? I like the way my daughter asks for things, but she doesn't get everything. She may just be playing with something. They will just come and I'll take. She's once she wants to say something good, say that he has a yes. Say, I need a new dress. And then I'll keep on. And she said, Daddy, did you hear me? I said, no, then. I'll continue what I'm doing. She will continue what she's doing. Check it out. Whether the dress is going to come in 6 months time, no, then. Hello? That is the way God deals with our choice.
Sometimes some of us just wake up when there are more important things to do, when there are serious matters on ground.
Say, Lord, I need a new car. God will say, I'm ready. Change the car you need. But he has the priority to deliver a car to you at his own time. So, when you are asking, take note of the following.
When you are seeking, take note of the following.
Number one,
ask with persistence and importunity.
What is importunity?
Constant and insistent demand.
Hello?
Constant and insistent demand. It is your right. Just like it's our right as parents to provide for our children. But you must be sure
that that is a need and not a want. Hello? I don't know whether we talk about some approved divine list. Like we talked at the front, there are some things that is your basic right to have. For instance, you have a wife, you have a husband, it is your right to have a child. And no,
because that is in the Bible. That is in the will of God for your life. So if you have any demand for a child, do it consistently, persistently, and with importunity until God gets willing.
My prayer, look at where we are. The unjust judge says,
although I don't fear anyone, but I will attend to this woman. With the asking. If you get what you say, heaven is a peace. Go and satisfy my daughter.
Because she will not let us have peace.
In prayer.
But we give up too easily. You know the story of Elijah and the king of Israel. Elijah and the king of Israel. When Elijah was to die, and the king of Israel came to him.
And he said to him, my Lord, the child of Israel, what are we going to do about this king of Syria?
Elijah said, open the window, put your bow and arrow in place, shoot it, take your bow,
begin to drop you down. One, two, three, and it's gone. He said, what's going to stop? I ask you to strike the ground. But not to stop. Because you stop three times.
You will only defeat the kingdom of Syria three times. That's where many of us are. You're asking God for a child. When in your family, people don't deliver on time, which means they force contending with you, and you are praying 2 minutes later, you can't go in anywhere.
Don't
does not do that.
Just ask in faith and believe.
It will be given you.
What about the other man?
What do we do?
Somebody
is praying for a car from God. Oh God, give me a car. I need a
salon car,
air condition. The next day, he applies for loan. Hello? He applies for loan to get a car. That car was bought by loan and not from God. And we have no problem paying the loan. When you are asking from God, you wait for God to act in reply.
That's why those who exercise real faith
are poor people. Say, God, dear man, I don't have a problem. I look up to you and you alone. And God. Praise the Lord. You are
asking God for something,
and you are looking for another way out. You are doubting God's ability. So, is it wrong for us to help ourselves? Lord, I want to build a house. I'm going to take a loan. Help me to pay the bank this loan. God will help you to pay back the loan. You will take the loan. It's God that still did it. But it's different from when you are saying, God, build me a house. I'm waiting for the miracle of God building a man a house. And how does it work? You just property. And you don't have money, you say, okay, let me start with 100,000. And you go and get foundation. Tomorrow, 100,000 come. You are setting block. Next tomorrow, 200,000. You are buying cement.
Sometimes when you finish the house, your bank account is still like 100,000.
But you are building a house. That's not money.
That is God building a house for you.
Not to take a mortgage and
it's simple, but I'm talking about when your faith is at work.
Praise the Lord. How many of you understood what that was said? God bless you.
So as in faith,
a woman was trusting God for the fruit of the womb.
Doctor has said no way.
He said, God gave me a woman to deliver. She went to buy baby clothes. Every morning she wakes up, saying, her baby is for the
baby, how are you? Good morning.
She prepares for the day and left. Sooner or later she conceived, a baby came to that court. Praise the Lord. That is
faith. The Bible said, show me your faith by what? You move in action. Like I said,
you are not ready, isn't it? But by faith, you are laying foundation.
By faith,
100,000 tomorrow, 200 next month, it has to be.
That is where we learn
the ability. Many a time, there is no food to eat. Why don't you fast in the morning and say, Lord, I trust you that in the evening, who eat something? If you do, you will know that God does not fail. My brother was testifying that the other day, he's the pastor, he's the leader, who were going to visit them. So I said to my wife, what do you think we should give them? It's not the Christmas time. I think it was April. My wife said, let's buy a bag of rice.
I said, no,
So we bought a bag of rice and we're going together. That morning, my wife, my brother's wife told me that the rice we are eating is the last one in the house. Not that they cannot afford it. He said he told her, God will provide. She was not going to make it. We are meeting the last one. In the afternoon, we arrived later. And I carried the bag of rice. Immediately I entered inside the house, the man laughed. He laughed. Men that knew that God cannot forget them. Men that knew that God is the source of provision. He told me, he said, do you know what? He began to narrate his story, and I said, that is God. Praise the Lord. Who told you he cannot provide for you also? Just exercise your faith. Number three, ask according to his will. Very important. Ask according to his will. 1 John chapter 5, verse 14 and 15. And this is the confidence that we have in him. That if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have a petition that we desire of him. As I come to this week, when I was a younger Christian, I used to ponder over this thing. How do I know the will of God in order to ask?
No, it's as simple as A, B, C. It is the will of God that you and I will eat food, isn't it?
So ask for food. That's what the Bible said. Pray like this. Give us this day.
Our what?
It is the will of God, like I said, for a man and woman who are married to have a child. Because he said, he blessed
them. But believe it or not.
God created us, but not all of us are the children of God. I don't care whether I'm in church, because my knowledge and experience have shown that they are church goers and they are Christians. Except you are born again with a solid relationship with the Lord, you are not a child of God. You are wicked. The Bible talks about the wicked. And it says, the prayer of the wicked is an abomination to God. No, it doesn't have to do with your ability to pray. It has nothing to do with your ability to buy, lose. No, the Bible says that. Going to 1 John chapter 3. I want to project it. 1 John chapter 3 and verse. Let's begin to read from verse 5, or verse 6. 1 John chapter 3 from verse 6. Whosoever abideth in him, sinneth not. Whosoever, this is a new thing, whosoever sinneth hath not seen him, neither know him. Verse 7. Little children, let no one deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. Verse 8. Where are you going to take this?
He that committeth sin, yes, this is what before, is of the devil. For the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested,
that he might destroy the works of the devil. Verse 9.
Whosoever is born.
Relationship. last year, I still saw her in the bed, and she's not mine, not mine. But I still felt. But from that day, she knew that this one is a good woman. It was a cheap offer. My wife is not there. My friends are not there. We are in a room. But God was there. I have this seed in me. I cannot desire sin. Am I talking to someone?
That's why when I make demand from God, if it doesn't come now, it will come.
Hello?
Demand the vision is for an appointed time. Don't need to enter. Wait for it.
If you want, it will surely come. Praise the Lord.
Violence
in the spirit is what will sustain you. That's why when I see people today, they fall into sin, they say, this,
I know that you want me to control,
but there is a limit of things to allow.
If I have gone
to that lady and I'll be rubbing her back and say, you know, I'm a Christian, you know. She said, we rub my back. I know. And when it happened, I'm saying, it's the devil. Devil my shit. Glory be to God. So, brothers and sisters, ask according to his will. You will get it. It may take long, but it will come. At disappointed time, the Bible says he makes all things beautiful in his time. Rule number three, since we can discuss this in a few minutes and continue next Sunday, because next Sunday I'll be talking on two things simultaneously. Rule number three, total obedience to divine instruction will make God to give you what you want. Rule number three, divine rule for divine provision, total obedience to divine instruction.
Divine instruction, number one, you must know, is evangelism.
Oh, Master, some of you know, it's in the word of God.
John 15 and verse 16. Ye have not chosen me,
but
I have chosen you and ordained you that you may go forth and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit may abide then whatsoever.
Praise the Lord.
Whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father
in my name, he will give it to you. No more problem we share to realize is that
every person in the Bible has a condition.
People will come and say, for instance, my
boss has supplied all my name.
What I read is anywhere. He didn't say for everybody. Not for everybody. He was
talking to people who gave, people who met it, people who gave sacrificially. He said, because you did this, my God.
And then he said to everywhere, and very often of waiting and said, my God shall
supply all my needs.
According to. And then he said, ah, bro. We want to use your motto to go to evangelism. Say, ah, the shock of God is very bad. And where are we going? From here to maybe Abuleka, how do you go through that? Because you don't want your faith to be used. There was somebody, we had the acceleration in their heart. He said, no.
It's a bomb. Every time they come in, they take it out of the road. You don't want to be sent out again.
And tomorrow we will say,
my God shall supply.
When we cannot match your rock in your house, which God? Praise the Lord.
Yeah, the Bible says, I have ordained you that you may go and do evangelism. If you can obey this instruction, whatsoever. Ticket to plant church.
Or how many Christians evangelize today? No thanks to the world. They are bombarding us with a lot of things. Somebody will put bomb around themselves, blow up everything. They will be rejoicing that it's going to happen.
Because it's fulfilling the mandate of his religion.
Of Christianity.
Say, no, don't make noise, Lord. Don't disturb your neighbor.
With your religion.
Say, yes. When you pray at night, pray quietly.
You say, yes, you know. Well, devil is so deceiving us. If you don't want to hear the gospel, don't hear it. But God bless you. Jesus loves you. Then can we talk? Say, no, get up. Thank you. You have heard it. Amen.
And it shall stand against you on the day of judgment. Because the Bible said, anybody that rejects you, dust your feet.
He said, on the day of judgment, it will be worse for that person. You may attempt. There are many of us there. We have never preached one day. And when we are calling believers, you are not an apostle. We are not a believer, we are a church goer. Hello. I beg you, I'm not insulting you. I'm preaching the word of God. So pardon me. Don't say I'm insulting you. Because you want deliverance,
it's a history. If a man be in Christ, it's a new creature. All things are passing away, and all things are becoming. What is it verse 18?
Oh, in verse 18, there's a responsibility there. We don't live there. Because responsibility is there. We like to live there. Open to 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 18. Are you there? Or read it for me. What has become of this song? I don't know. Read it, you see. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 18, 1, 8.
And all things are of God, who have reconciled us unto himself by Christ Jesus, and have given unto us the ministry of reconciliation.
You know what? 17. Is something you can possess. Verse 18 is something you can give. Many of us don't know 18. It's a local area. But sir, this is your first ministry to win souls. And if you keep to it, there will be divine provision from on high. Number 2, instruction.
Divine instruction to pay your tithe. It's a divine instruction.
Oh, time will not permit me to read, but I will try. Malachi 3 verse 10 to 12. Bring ye all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now, hear it, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for thy sake, and it shall not destroy thy fruit, the fruit of thy ground, neither shall your wine cast a fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts, and all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, saith the Lord of hosts.
Great promises.
Do you think God cannot fulfill it? No, brother, he can. But you are not meeting your obligation. I see a lot of people, they pay that in January, mathematicians. They give 3 months, they drop something. They put another 3 months, they drop something. And when something is wrong,
God is fitting. Do we need to be for that for myself?
In fact, your own people are the mouth to be very big. It will devour and devour and devour. Praise the Lord.
So, brother, you know also what the Malachi chapter 3 said? Ye are cursed with a curse because you wrong God. So if you don't pay your tithes, you bring the curse upon yourself. First and foremost. First and foremost.
And a lot of Christians will pay tithes. A lot.
And again, you too will say you are a Christian. No, you are a church one. A Christian that cannot obey simple instruction from God is not a believer. He's a church one. Divine instruction for better. That is why you know, I said it before.
You don't talk of giving your time.
And from this at all, you pay your time because it's a debt to God. It's a debt. He said, 10% of your income
belong to me. And a lot of us would rather do it to man. For instance, why is it that there are political godfather fighting with their son? Because they bring gold. Boy, I'm sponsoring you, but you get there. Every month, deliver 20 million. Say, don't stop. When Ndike did it, he think he can be smart. He did not meet his obligation with all his superior security. They kidnap him. And they went to pick him somewhere. State government. That can only happen in Nigeria. Obasanjo was in charge. And they told Obasanjo, he said, and each two should go and meet his obligation in Nigeria. But that's to tell you that if you don't meet your obligation, there is a problem with men as well as with God. God gave you money, you eat up the money, and you eat up also that the Jews need some paper, it will not digest. May the Lord help us.
So, obey that instruction, and heaven
will move on your behalf.
Number three, divine instruction. Divine instruction to give and to sow.
Everybody said to give and to sow. So you give your offering, you give to your fellow man, you sow a seed. And I want to warn us, if I will not share for you, when Prophet came, that's when I know that a lot of people, he won in church, and people stood. That's nothing happened. The man left, they did not pay.
I said, people are telling God. Not only that, you made a vow. Even if you see your closet in the toilet,
there is God and you don't pay it. You're in trouble.
Divine instruction to give. Share
with another person. You are not helping yourself. I told you, our red emblem, that you see and vows. Make the vow, come here, ask for the red envelope, whether we call you or drop you.
But I did say, save for me a week.
When we say bring it, as people go to I forgot. 59, what is that?
Are you walking forward? Are you walking forward? Are you glad that you don't give at all? That will provoke his anger.
You say that's a widow's mind, it's a lie. It's not a widow's mind. Listen to me. There is a stage you get to. You search your pocket and you look, you want to give up, it's
29. Don't give up in that day. And you, if you are not prepared yourself for offering, don't give. Don't give. Because I've given you an analogy before. If you call a child and say you want to, today, you want to bless a child or say a teenager, and you call and say, come. You have raised a rope, or he's overcome and he's smiling to you. Uncle, just put down the pocket. Got 5 naira for a teenager. It will cost you for a heart. And then he or she will cost you his heart. It will better you don't give him love than to call a teenager. Average correct biscuit is 29, and you are giving it 5 naira. May God have mercy. And then many of you, instead of dancing to the front and dancing back, say, Lord, I give my dance offering. And those correct persuaded inside, you dance to the front and drop 5 naira as offering. You are mortgaging your chances of prosperity. I'm not cursing you, but in my village, they said, it is the kolanut that befits a king that you give to him. Hello? Want to give kolanut to a king? You can't bring any other kolanut. God help you. If you throw away the king, ask for your help, because you have insulted him. May God help us. I pray that God will give us understanding. Listen to me. I'm not afraid to say it. We are not. You know why that Jesus said we should be dancing? Dancing out to give us one. He said, God is not a beggar. Sometimes you have seen ushers here. We want to give offering, they will bring the basket and say, return it.
The instructions of our father in God. Some of us may sit down and you bring up your bag and you don't drop anything. And sometimes you don't cause the usher or using the offering bag to touch something. Say, why don't you touch my shirt?
And I'm going to do it. God is not a beggar. So he says, if you want to give your offering, drop it, dance out to show. To show that you are honoring him. To show that the one you have given to you have respect for him. And I see some people respectfully,
they want to throw offering in the bag.
You have given to God what I have. Some people, they want to throw offering. They are just coming.
I want some offering.
This is your offering bag. You just have. Are you giving to a beggar? You know that when you give money to a beggar, you throw it at them.
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, this is what is hindering our blessing.
If you think that God is not interested in offering, why was Jesus Christ looking? He said they were giving offering.
And when they finished, he said, all these people, it's only this widow that gave the best. Because she gave it,
she gave out of her.
For we may have it, but won't give. We were praying in workers' meeting. One of our workers was saying, let's pray. When we come to church, we see our cars. When it comes to giving, people who don't want to give God. Just on Friday night, one of our workers who was leading us was saying we should pray and God will touch our heart. Because people believe that if they give, the pastor and his family will flourish. I'm trusting God for one day, like a man of God did. I will get to a point where any congregation that I pastor will not give more than I do. Even here, we are not up to 30% that can give more than me in this church. Praise the Lord. My prayer is that every night, pastor, I will be the number one giver. Praise the Lord. don't. And I don't pray, I will do that.
So stop deceiving yourself. Stop hindering yourself. Give so that you will be blessed. Whatever you give is the church of God, God's
with the money. It's not your business. You are giving to God. And I would like to end and say, listen to me, brethren. God is not so much interested in your giving than in your life. He's more interested in your life than the substance you give. Therefore, your relationship matters most. Your relationship is more important. Your relationship is more serious than what you pay in your life. Bow down your head as you pray. Say, Father, touch my life today. Every knowledge I need to have in order to command the blessing of God, Lord, grant unto me. Give me knowledge of divine provision. Give me knowledge of divine grace. Give me knowledge of divine help. Give me knowledge of divine power. Give me knowledge in the name of Jesus Christ, my Father and my God. Lord, help me. Let the purpose to give my life every day to you in form of success. Pray and say, Father, in this month of divine provision, the rules, the knowledge, the understanding that I need to have in order to get my divine provision. Lord, grant unto me. Knowledge is power. Knowledge empowers a man. And if you are here this morning, you are not born again, you have not surrendered your life to Christ. Father, please touch such a one. I pray for you, and God will touch you. But you need to surrender and say, God, touch me. Make me your child. Give me a relationship. Who is that person? Who is that person? Who is that person? You want to surrender to Jesus? You are not born again. You can do so now. You become a child of God. You will